Welcome, guys. This is Sibuyupane in Botswana, just on the Botswanan side of the Zimbabwe-Botswana border, about 40 k's southwest of Pandamatenga border post, a very isolated, very remote place. And we are here to look for the baobab of Sibuyupane, tree number 48. In Lynn Mullen's Historic Trees of Zimbabwe. Now, as you can see, I'm not standing by a baobab because I haven't actually found the tree. I found the pan, it's here, and there's no sign of the tree. I don't know if I'm just not looking in the right place or if the tree's gone. The thing with baobab trees is when they die, they just completely disappear. They very, very, very quickly decompose because it's very soft material. So it's very hard to know if a baobab tree has died. And like all living things, even though they live to a very, very ripe old age, sometimes 2,000, 2,500 years old, they do die. So the baobab that was found here at this spot by this pan was used by travelers in the 1880s up through to the 1920s, 1930s as shade and shelter. This was the long route up to Victoria Falls if you were coming from Cape Town. Prior to the construction of the railway, you would come by horse or by wagon, and this was the route. This road here is called the Old Hunters Road, and a lot of travelers came up here. And on this baobab tree, had I been able to find it, and perhaps were it still standing, you would have found a lot of travelers' initials carved on it, including a cross and a quote from Acts in the Bible, which was put on the tree by Jesuit missionaries between 1880 and 1885, when there used to be a missionary station at Pandamatenga. Also, interestingly, were the initials ED, which is Ted Davis from 1931, who was the first warden of Wangi National Park and also the custodian of the Salu tree, another tree that I have already featured in this ongoing series on historic trees of Zimbabwe. A quick word on baobabs and their longevity. There has been a bit of a story recently about old baobabs dying prematurely because of climate change. And I would just like to give my quick opinion on that. Baobabs are incredibly tolerant of drought, and I don't think that I could really say that I feel that baobab trees are dying because of changing climatic conditions in this part of the world. The trees that were in the study were all chosen because they were extremely old. And it's kind of like taking a bunch of 90-year-old people and studying them for a year and then saying after the year, oh my goodness, some of them have died. Well, yes, but they were 90. That's why you chose them. So the trees that were chosen for this study, 15 different trees, were between 1,500 and 2,500 years old. They were studied over something like a 15-year period, and in that time, four or five of them died. To be honest, I don't think that's that surprising. And I personally have seen very, very, very many signs that the baobab population in Southern Africa is generally very strong and very healthy. Sadly, the baobab at Sibuyupane was not here, and maybe it's because I wasn't looking in the right place. Alright guys, thanks for watching. My name's Gus, the African Plant Hunter. If we haven't met before, this is what I do, little vignettes about African trees and plants. You're very welcome to join me for more. You can see plenty on my YouTube channel, Instagram, Facebook, africanplanthunter.com. I'd love to see you again, and till the next time, check you later, bye.